Hello and welcome. In this video, I will present the summarized story of Moses' journey. This will take us first into Egypt, to Mount Sinai, Kadesh Barnea, and to his mysterious death. No one knows where he is buried, if he was buried. However, I have some interesting information that you will never see discussed anywhere. I will leave out the details regarding the Exodus event itself, as that is a video all on its own. Many researchers, including myself, have concluded that the mountain known as Jabal al-Laz in Saudi Arabia is the actual Mount Sinai. Some researchers do not agree with that, but I did make a video regarding the discovery of the holy ground at Mount Sinai, which I discovered. Click on the link on the upper right corner to view that video if you need to be convinced that Jabal al-Laz is in fact Mount Sinai. Let us begin. So around 1785 BC, the Hebrews begin migrating to Egypt, into the Nile Delta. The pharaoh at the time was Euphni. In 1650 BC, the Hyksos conquer Memphis and begin their rule of Lower Egypt, which is from the Mediterranean Ocean to the first cascades of the Nile River. I agree with other researchers that believe the Hyksos are from the same Asiatic tribes from Canaan, including the Hebrew tribes. Around 1615 BC, Moses is born, though that was not likely his name. Moses is a title. I have no evidence for this birth suggestion, but I believe he was born in Buto. This is in Lower Egypt. Around 1574 BC, Moses self-exiles to Midian. He is 40 years old and will spend 40 years there. At Midian, he meets his father-in-law, Jethro, marries one of his daughters, and has two sons. Notice that Midian is about 22 miles from Jabal al-Laz. The mountain I have confirmed is the real Mount Sinai. Around 1535 BC, Moses' brother Aaron reaches out to Moses to help lead the Hebrews out of Egypt. He proposes to meet Moses halfway. I estimate that Aaron's journey started around November 1st of 1535 BC. The distance from Goshen, also known as Avaris, which was the Hyksos capital, to Midian is 535 kilometers. That's through the Sinai Peninsula and over the Strait of Titan, which I believe is the path that was taken. In order to meet someone halfway, both parties have to know the route beforehand. And since Moses had already traveled to Midian, where he lived for 40 years up to this point, it's obvious both he and his brother knew this route, as there is only one safe path, as the area is surrounded by hostile bands of thieves. It's my hypothesis that they crossed through the natural land bridge at the Strait of Titan. The copper mining town of Succoth seems like a likely location for the brothers to meet roughly halfway and return to Egypt. The following year, I estimate around April 1 or 4, Moses leads the Hebrews out of Egypt towards Mount Sinai. This is the period that coincides with the army from Upper Egypt by Amos I, who came to defeat the Hyksos at Avaris, also known as Goshen. Moses arrives at Mount Sinai about 6 weeks later, and they spend just under a year there. Around March of 1533 BC, the Jews arrive at Kadesh Barnea, which I believe is Petra. The evidence clearly supports Petra as being Kadesh Barnea. Here are the points. Number one, Wadi Musa is 3 kilometers beside it. Here is a definition of Wadi and Musa. Number two, the tomb of Aaron is 2 kilometers from Petra. Number three, the suspected tomb of Miriam, Moses' sister, is also 2 kilometers from Petra. Number four, the obelisk tomb, could that be Moses' tomb? Number five, the altar of sacrifice, no other cultures in the area performed ritual sacrifices. Number 6. The Great Temple, center of ancient Petra. Number 7. Petra is almost exactly halfway from Mount Sinai to Mount Nebo, where they attacked Jericho from in 1250 BC. Finally, number 8. Petra is in a direct line from Mount Sinai to Mount Nebo through completely friendly territory. Moses died in 1494 BC. Egypt still controlled the Levant up until 1250 BC. The Jews did not move to Mount Nebo and Moab until close to 1250 BC. It is my conclusion that Moses died at Kadesh Barnea, which is Petra. Note that Israel is visible from several peaks around Petra, including from Aaron's tomb. I have a look here where I marked the border with Israel in blue, and as we will zoom in on to Aaron's tomb location, we will scout the area and we'll be able to see that blue line, and that, you know, from there, that is Israel. The Nabataeans, them. The Jews left the area around 1200 BC, and the Nabataeans, which are descendants of Ishmael, arrived around the year 400 BC. They have no history of building anything spectacular, such as found in Petra. However, the Egyptians sure did.
So where is Moses buried? Scripture says somewhere near Mount Nebo, near a place called Beth Peor. The Bible, in Deuteronomy 32:50, mentions that he is to die atop a mountain like his brother Aaron. Had Moses been murdered, had committed suicide or died in battle, there would be something in the scriptures about it. When a man reaches 120 years of age, while the average person during the time period lived to less than half that age, he is left alone. I can imagine that he gave many sermons at the theater until he could not do so. Without evidence, we are left with the kiss of death from God, which can be interpreted from some verses that refer to from the mouth of Yahweh. In today's terms, that would be old age. An obelisk over a tomb is an ancient Egyptian practice used to honor special people and gods. The Nabataeans are reported to have built the one at Petra. However, it could have been either a rebuild of a previous obelisk honoring Moses, or they may simply have destroyed the old one and built their own at the same spot. The Jews would have all left together for Mount Nebo some 500 years before, leaving no one behind to talk about the place's history to any newcomers. Because the arguments for Petra are convincing, my opinion is that Moses is buried below the obelisk at Petra. I hope you find this video informative. Thank you for watching. God bless.